Welcome again. Today we'll look at the next method, which is lead. The Latin name lambam, PB, is the chemical symbol. Okay, now in lead, there's not much to talk about. So we start with the main ore, which is known as galena, whose formula is lead 2 sulfide. So this is the main ore. Then, for lead, one thing before we proceed, let me mention that it is also a transition element, and it forms compounds with a variety of oxidation states, or it has a variety of oxidation numbers to be precise. And the two main oxidation numbers, we have lead 2 and lead 4. So within your course of revision, you might find one compound being referred to, for example, lead 2 oxide, and another one, lead 4 oxide. So those two compounds are compounds of the same element, which is lead, but lead at different oxidation states. So take note of that clearly. Now, this ore, the main impurity is silica. And the chemical name for silica is silicon 4 oxide, whose formula is that SiO2, silicon 4 oxide. Now, when it comes to extraction of lead, it is important for you to note that the method used is reduction. That is the method that you use to obtain lead from galena. But note this, the lead you get from galena by reduction method is not 100% pure, and for that reason, the purification is done by electrolysis, or purification is by electrolytic method. So we are going to discuss both of them, but remember, reduction is the method that we use to obtain lead from the main ore. So what is done during reduction? First of all, you have to grind the ore into powder. And whenever you are grinding the ore into powder, the main reason is to increase surface area for the reactions that will occur in subsequent stages. In powder form, a solid has a larger surface area than it is in maybe granulated forms or other bigger particles. Then, the next thing that you do after you grind the ore is that you mix with limestone, which is calcium carbonate, and coke, which is carbon. These are meant to provide it, either to act directly or indirectly in the process of reduction. Like we know, for calcium carbonate, when you heat it, we get calcium oxide and carbon 4 oxide. This one is happening in a furnace. It is happening in a furnace. So this is where we are getting these high temperatures to decompose calcium carbonate. Then carbon 4 oxide undergoes reduction by coke and we form carbon 2 oxide gas. So carbon 2 oxide and coke act as our main reducing agents. And how do they function? First of all, before we go to reduction, the first thing that happens before you even mix the ore with the calcium carbonate and the coke, there is a step that should have been here, is lead sulfide. So here, let's fix a step, roasting the ore. And roasting, we mean simply heating the ore in supply of oxygen, that is particularly in air. So lead sulfide plus oxygen, you get lead oxide, sulfur ore oxide. Remember, make sure your equations are balanced. So let's see how we are going to balance. With a 2 here, we have to put a 2 here. Another one here for the sake of lead. So oxygen, we have 6. That is 2 times 2, 4 plus 2, 6. And therefore we have to put a 3 at this point. So, from this step, we get lead oxide. Lead oxide now is what you mix with calcium carbonate and coke. So that calcium carbonate gives us carbon 4 oxide, which is reduced to carbon 2 oxide by coke. And then these two, coke and carbon 2 oxide, are now our reducing agents, which we are going to use to reduce lead to oxide. Okay? Now, with lead to oxide, the next thing that happens simply is, let's see how reduction occurs. If it is using carbon, we get lead and carbon 4 oxide. And the equation is balanced in that form. If it is using carbon 2 oxide, we have lead oxide, carbon 2 oxide, you form lead, carbon 4 oxide. And this one, it is balanced when it is like this. And always know that carbon 2 oxide, this one here, it is always the main reducing agent. And just to remind you the reason for that, it is in gaseous state and therefore it provides a larger surface area for reaction with the solid ore that we have in that furnace. So even if reduction occurs by the help of carbon, it is less than what is done by carbon 2 oxide. Then it is important to note this. In case there is some lead sulfide that was left without being converted into lead oxide in this step here, when you are roasting the original ore, in case there was some lead sulfide left without being oxidized to lead oxide, or without being converted to lead oxide precisely, what is done is iron, solid iron or iron powder, is added to the lead sulfide. The two are reacted. Iron powder, you introduce iron powder into the same furnace. What is the reason for this? Iron is higher than lead in the reactor. activity series. And therefore, it is going to reduce lead from lead to sulfide, because if you calculate the oxidation number of lead in this compound, you'll find that it is 2. So lead to sulfide is going to be converted into lead. The oxidation number of lead here is 0. So simply what has taken place here is reduction has taken place. Even if necessarily, there is no oxygen that is being transferred. We are talking about reduction in terms of oxidation number. While iron, whose oxidation number was originally 0, will now be converted into iron 2 sulfide. And in this case, like we are saying, iron 2. That tells you the oxidation number of iron has increased from 0 to positive 2. So this one is simply a redox kind of a reaction. And as you can see, we are obtaining lead from lead sulfide. So since the final compound that we want is lead, this step will also enable us to get lead from the lead sulfide that remained and reacted in the previous steps. So we end up with the lead, which will be collected in molten state. So the best state symbol actually here is liquid. Because of the high temperatures in the furnace, the lead will be collected in molten form. But in the process, we have iron 2 sulfide. And remember, in the previous, or when we were starting this process, we said that the main impurity present in the main ore of lead, which is galena, is silicon 4 oxide. So how are we going to do away with the impurity? So silicon 4 oxide is going to react with the calcium oxide we get from decomposition of calcium carbonate. The two solids are going to react and we form calcium silicate. So calcium silicate and iron 2 sulfide, these two are going to form slag. And the slag is also going to be tapped off in molten state at the lower parts of the furnace, but it cannot mix with molten lead since they are of different densities. So the two cannot mix together because of the difference in their relative densities. Okay? So with that, we have obtained molten lead. But it is important for you to note that this lead is not 100% pure. And therefore, we have to go through a small step of purification. So, when it is molten, first of all, you can bubble air through the molten lead. And the importance of this air is that the oxygen in the air is going to oxidize some of the substances or some of the elements that are mixed with the lead to form other substances that are of less density that will float on the molten lead and they can be skimmed off. And if they are gaseous, they can even escape into the atmosphere. But now, to obtain 100% pure lead, that one is done by electrolysis. And how it does that happen? You simply set an electrolytic cell this is the cathode and this is the anode. We are considering the terminal of the battery. The cathode, at the cathode you put some pure lead. You get some pure lead and make it the cathode. Then this impure lead, after it solidifies, the impure lead that you have gotten from this process you make it the anode. So the anode is made up of impure lead. We shall see why. And why you cannot do the other way around. And then the electrolyte, this one is a solution of lead ions. A solution containing lead ions, which maybe you can use a substance like lead nitrate. A solution containing lead ions. So, very quickly, let's see what happens in this case. Now, starting with the anode, remember we always say that at the anode, oxidation occurs. But this time round, we have a special condition. The anode is made up of lead. The electrolyte is made up of lead ions. So what is going to happen in this case? The lead atoms that are making up the anode are going to be oxidized to form lead ions, which are going to go into the solution. Which means we have lead atoms forming lead ions plus two electrons. Each lead atom, once it loses two electrons, that is when it forms lead ions. So this is oxidation because electrons are being released. Come to the cathode. And we know very well, after the cathode, that is where reduction occurs. And the reduction means gaining of electrons. So here, what is going to happen here? The lead ions present in the solution, remember the solution is made up of lead ions. So the lead ions present in the solution are going to take up two electrons released at the anode. And we are going to form lead metal or lead atoms. And this now will be pure lead. So simply, we are getting lead from the impure, taking it to the pure electrode. And for that reason, the observation that is going to be made in this experiment is, from time to time, or through the experiment, the size of the anode is going to be reducing in size because we are dissolving the atoms into ions. While the size of the cathode is going to be increasing because that is where we are depositing pure lead. So with that, we have covered the process by which lead is obtained from galena. Do more questions. Go through the questions properly, step by step, understand the process. From there, answer questions. Don't just understand the process and leave it at that. We meet in the next lesson. Thank you very much.